thanksgiving in a place that is warm on these cool winter. Days. Homecomer, and she's also written a book called The Song Poet in honor and about her immigration as among her life as among immigrants, her family, and today for 3-year-old through 6th graders as well. Katie Erickson has an announcement for us. Trip. We have 7 spots. Are there still 2 open? We have 2 still available. So I'm pretty sure our paid for now. So we need people to fill them or we end up losing the payment that we've made on them this summer in July. For that trip. Also, the dinner, the shareholders' dinner when they return. A date is to be determined. So we don't have a date yet, but it'll be after their trip in the middle of July, so later in July or August. So we hope that you will, if you're able. Our service for confession and forgiveness is found in the front of your hymnal on page 94. Please stand. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty, you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. ourselves. We have Jesus Christ. Have mercy on us. Forgive us. Renew us. We continue on page 147 in the front of your hymnal. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Here there were
worship and proud, and defend us, gracious Lord.
Prayer of the day is printed on the front page of your bulletin. Because we receive what you promise. Make us love.
First lesson for the fourth Sunday after Epiphany.
he began to say to them, "Today this scripture has been fulfilled in your hearing." All spoke well of him and were amazed at the gracious words that came from his mouth. They said, "Is not this Joseph's son?" He said to them, "Doubtless you will quote to me this proverb, 'Doctor, cure yourself,' and you will say, 'Do here also in your hometown the things that we have heard you did at Capernaum.'" And he said, "Truly I tell you, no prophet is accepted in the prophet's hometown. But the truth is, there are many widows in Israel in the time of There were also many lepers in Israel in the time of the prophet Elisha, and none of them was cleansed except Naaman the Syrian." When they heard this, all in the synagogue were filled with rage. They got up, drove him out of town, and led him to the brow of the hill on which their town was built, so that they might hurl him off the cliff. But he passed through the midst of them and went on his way. The Gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
Christ. Amen. The Lord needed someone to be bold, someone who would speak the truth and trust the Lord would get him through. God's people were doing what was evil in the sight of the Lord, and they wouldn't repent when the Lord called. So now he's searching for yet another prophet to deliver his word. And the be an advocate of the Torah to those who mock the Ten Commandments. The good these people had not stopped loving them. And he would assure his beloved of the newness of life. Because of the Lord's mercy, he knew what he was in for. Even though he seemed to have a sense that perhaps resistance would be good when the Lord called him to speak, he responded by saying, "Ah, Lord, I do not know how to speak." Now, some of you might remember that was Moses' response when the Lord told him to go back to Egypt. But the Lord isn't stopped with excuses. So Jeremiah keeps on. He says, "I'm only a boy." Maybe knowing the older generations were highly respected, and a child would not speak in public or in the presence of an older man unless asked to speak. Still, excuses don't work. The one who created him in the womb and chose him before birth is now calling and sending Jeremiah to go. This could be the reason we don't hear Jeremiah wonder, "What if I don't do the assignment?" Like perhaps a student would ask a teacher when the teacher says it's required. And the teacher responds, "You'll do the assignment." Perhaps then it is the trust of that child that does deliver. So the child goes, and the life he has is will of the Lord is not what his family expected for his future. So the call to speak for the Lord is fulfilled, and the one sent will soon experience the reality of the message he delivers. For he will always be the one between what the Lord would have him say and a people who do not want to hear the Lord's message. He will be the despised messenger with news too hard to hear and too unreal to want to believe. Perhaps on some level, we get it. We know what it means to speak truth on the level of community and neighborhoods and families, at least. When the one we love needs to stop driving and we are the ones who need to tell him. Or even if the doctor is the one to tell him, or maybe the doctor is the one who has told you, the reality is that the ones closest, often family, get the brunt of the frustration. Because we easily associate driving with independence, and when driving goes, life does really change. Hearing and speaking the truth, sometimes it seems like it's to nations, even when it's to the ones we love. As well. See, when Jeremiah was called Israel, and they even set up those altars in the temple, the land, the people realized how corrupt they'd become slowly over time. Yet anyone who may have tried to speak out against it would have been punished. So the corruption continued. And as a child in this community life, Jeremiah would speak, a prophet to his people. A prophet. The topic that Jesus addresses in today's gospel, that the one who grows our day too. The truth spoken and delivered got Martin Luther King Jr. killed one who can't under any other way of life. The truth in a community and in a home. Jeremiah goes to speak the Lord's truth to nations that would listen and then they would turn away again. Nations that could not and would not remain faithful. Nations that would continue to hear their Lord's persistence. Lord who is faithful to them despite the lives that have strayed. The Lord, who comes himself in Jesus, the very truth, the life he gives, the life he brings, would think, and he'd be driven out. Not for the last time. He'd be mobbed. He'd be tempted and he'd be arrested. He would be forced out of town with a cross on as his load. Because the good news he brings is disturbing to life. The good news Jesus brought was including outsiders like never before, was restoring life and making neighbors really uncomfortable. After all, how do you treat the one who's been crippled their whole life and is now able to walk and work and have a full life? So the ones who could see, who could hear the truth, were not those in power, but the ones who were changed by the Lord's power itself. by the power of the word that this Lord speaks. The call of Jeremiah would prove true for the Lord Jesus as well, who had come with the power to pluck up and pull down, destroy, overthrow, build, and plant. Because the good soil is not able to be planted. Will be tall, flowers abundant, and growth beyond our imagination. Than Yahweh, addressing elaborate and empty ritual that people had created, believing they could satisfy the then the Lord would and could be heard. Yet it seems the hearing would interesting it is to consider the call of Jeremiah and Jesus' address to his home, us into this education. When we're tempted to think we can't teach because we don't know the story of the Lord's truth and the truth of his calling. We don't have all the answers, but we do have one who leads us through. It's the same Lord who called and sent Jeremiah. It's the same Lord who came, lived among us, and died, and still lives, persistent. We don't have all the answers, but we do have one who leads. We have a Lord who remains faithful just as he faithfully led and was raised from the dead, and remains persistent to be our Lord still. And to this, when we can surely say, this is most certainly true. Amen. The peace of God that passes all understanding, guard and keep our hearts. faith using the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion. God's people and all of God's creation. In each other, not only in those we know, but in all of your people. Lord, in your mercy. You promised to strengthen and uphold your people, O Lord. And while all of us are in constant need of your kingdom is the greatest blessing to come, bring peace to those who await the day when you and an honorable way of life. Save us from violence, discord, and confusion, from pride and arrogance, and from every evil course of action. Make us who continue to come from many nations with many different languages a united people. Defend our liberties and give those whom we have entrusted and have yet to entrust with the authority of government the spirit of wisdom, that there might be justice and peace in our land. When times are prosperous, let our hearts be thankful. And in troubled times, O Lord, do not let our trust in you fail. Lord, in your mercy. Lord of life and healing, we pray for the hope and comfort of all who grieve. We know all too well the cost of close those saints who have gone before us. Give your peace that passes all ourselves, our time, and possessions. The disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, gave thanks, and gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the New Testament in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this for the remembrance of me." We pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us. Amen. You may be seated. The body of our Lord Jesus Christ and you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. Peace. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.